विद रेफरेंस टू अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट और अ पर्टिकुलर हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन, वी विल से वी मेजर द वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल एज अ लेवलिंग. ओके, सो व्हाई दिस लेवलिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड एक्चुअली. In leveling, actually, what we do, if we are using the auto level, what we are doing, we are creating one horizontal plane, and we are measuring the distances with respect to that particular horizontal plane. And this horizontal plane is required because you see, maximum floors, road, bridges, dams, they have a horizontal flat surface. So, in the construction industry, what we are supposed to do? Maximum times we are supposed to create a flat plane which is parallel to the parallel to what? Parallel to the water level, right? So this is what the auto level is. Okay, so some definitions are given there. Leveling, it is defined as the art of determining the relative heights or elevation of an object on the earth surface. How that we are going to measure, that we will see in detail. It deals with the measurement in the vertical plane. Okay, the automatic level is an easy to use surveying instrument. Instrument needs only to be set up within its circular level bubble, has a damping compensator which adjusts the line of collimation. Line of collimation is what? You might be aware of this. Surveying is already over, I think. And auto level is the simplest equipment in the land survey, isn't it? Okay, we'll see. Generally accurate to plus or minus 2 mm. So these are the some of the parts of the auto level. Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so this is known as the eyepiece. Okay, this portion is the eyepiece. Okay, this is nothing but the focusing knob. Focusing knob is for what? For adjustment of the focus. When you are seeing the staff that time, if there is a blur, then you have to focus with the help of this knob, right? On this side there is one. So actually circular level is over here. I will change the color, just a minute. Okay, the circular knob is here, but when you are looking from the telescope, that time it is not possible to see this. That's why one mirror is given over here. So reflection of this particular circular knob, it is seen here, and you can see that whether the instrument is level or is there any problem. Okay, peep sight. This particular object for the adjustment of the sight, approximate. First, you have to sight your this staff, okay, and after that you can level and you can do the fine tuning with this, with the help of this knob. Okay, this is a circular horizontal circle, okay, where you can measure the angle, right? And this is what, this is the foot screw for leveling the instrument. These two knobs here, This is for locking the horizontal plane. Okay, once you rotate and if you want to lock, you can lock it with the help of these knobs. So this is all about we saw just now. Okay, this is a tripod on which we mount this auto level, right? This is the staff and this one is the ranging rod, right? Now some of the terms that we use in the auto level, okay? A level datum. What is datum? A level surface to which elevation of a point to be points may be referenced means the benchmark, we say. Okay, datum is the bigger one. Benchmark is the temporary benchmark that we take on our site, and this is from the universal from where we are taking this benchmark level, right? So this is one of the reference, we can say. Reduced level is nothing but the elevation of a point in its vertical distance above or below the datum level. Fixed reference point of a known elevation, benchmark that we take on the site. Backside, it is the staff reading taken at a known elevation. It is the first staff reading taken after set up the instrument. Just now I am reading out these terms, okay? And in detail, actually what it is, we will see. Foresight, it is the staff reading taken denoting the shifting of the instrument. Intermediate sight, it is a staff reading taken on a point whose elevation is to be determined. All staff reading between the backsight and foresight are intermediate sights. Change point, it is the point on which foresight and backsights are taken. Line of collimation. It is a line joining the intersection of the cross hairs of diaphragm to the optical center of the object glass, and its continuation is known as line of collimation. Then height of instrument. It is the elevation of the line of collimation with respect to the datum. Okay, so you studied all the terms. Okay, now the actual practice will start. This is the sketch. Okay, can anyone tell me what is the principle that we use in the auto level survey? Sketch is in front of you. What exactly we do? The basic, the concept is what? Terms, it is okay. Foresight, backsight, height of instrument, temporary benchmark, change point. We know all the definitions. Now it is the time to actually implement, right? So what is the principle of a auto level equipment? What does it exactly do? And what actually we do when we do the survey? Anyone has any idea? No? Okay. We'll come to this sketch later on, just for it. Now you know the auto level, okay? And this is the area where you are supposed to do the survey, right? Why these levels are required? Okay, in auto level, what we find out the reduced level of the different points of the ground. Actually, why it is required to find out the different levels of the ground. What you think? What is the use of that particular survey afterward? Anyone has any idea?
Sir, for leveling purpose.
Yes, but why leveling is required? Okay, you did everything. Foresight, backsight, reduced level, there will be 100 points and there you will prepare one table, isn't it? In that particular table, what you will do? You will point out all the these reduced levels, isn't it? Now, with the help of that table, what you are going to do next?
Forgot the horizontal surface where the cutting is done, where the filling.
Exactly, right. So your purpose is that, I just now I told you, if there is a building, then you need a horizontal plane, isn't it? You need a horizontal plinth level, you need a horizontal slab, isn't it? If the road is there, then you also you need a horizontal plane. Okay, but natural ground level is not horizontal perfectly, isn't it? There will be definitely some undulations. Okay, then why auto level? Just bring JCB and just cut the area, fill the area, khatam. Why this is required? With the auto level, we are not going to cut and fill. And we know that cutting filling is required. So directly bring the JCB or whatever the equipment is required and cut it, fill it, khatam. Why the survey is required? Before doing anything, an engineer must know what is the root, why it is required. Then only you can do the work properly, isn't it? Without knowing the purpose of the work, if you are doing it, is a clerical work. Because clerk, they don't know for what they are doing. They are just following the instruction from their boss. But an engineer, he must know what is the purpose of this particular work. Any idea? Abhijit, any idea?
No, sir.
Okay. Actually, it is very simple. If you don't know the cutting and filling quantity, then how you are going to do the quantity estimation? How you are going to do the budget? How you are going to do the calculation of the budget? Isn't it?
Right, sir. Right, sir.
If there is a project of a building project or road project or any project, first, what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to calculate the budget for that particular project, isn't it? So for that purpose, actually, there are two, three different purposes, right? Even for billing, for example, you have appointed some contractor, okay? And he has done with JCB cutting and filling, and you don't know how much cutting is there, how much filling is there, then how you are going to pay your contractor, isn't it? So
yes, sir.
With the help of these levels, we can calculate the cutting and filling quantity. Okay, for that purpose, these levels are required. With the help of these levels, what we do, we actually prepare the contour plan. Right? Okay, now you understood why we are preparing all these things. Now we will proceed further, then how to do this now and what is the principle. Okay, I am going to the some other text. What you can see here, you can see one horizontal circular plane is there, isn't it? This white color, can everyone see this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is this? This is nothing but your plane of collimation. You are saying line, I am saying plane. Okay, why plane? Because it is not a single line. Okay, if once your instrument is leveled perfectly, okay, so then what happens? This line, you see, you call it as a line of collimation, this one. Oh, just a minute. This line, isn't it? You are watching from here. Your staff may be here somewhere, maybe far away. Right now I'm showing here. So this line is your line of sight, right? So this line has to be in a perfect horizontal plane. Then only your reading will be perfect. Then only your survey will be perfect. Okay. If this line has some angle, for example, I will show you. Okay. So your leveling is not perfect. What will happen? Your line will be like this. I have just exaggerated this one. Okay. So your line will be like this. So all your reading will be wrong. So the basic principle is that you are going to create one perfect horizontal line or plane. In that particular plane, okay, in that particular plane, you can keep your staff anywhere. If you keep your staff here, for example, here, say, you will keep it here, or you can keep it here. Here, or you can keep it here, right? What do you see? You see that this particular reading is more as compared to this, as compared to this, right? From this equipment, you are going to see the three stops, correct? Now, can anyone tell me which level is down? This level, or this level? Ground level, I'm saying. Which level is down? A. For example, this is point A, this is point B, and say this is point C. So, which ground level? Yes.
A
is down, right? Then what about the staff reading? Will it be more or less?
More, sir.
It will be more. Okay, now with this photo, it is very clear. Wherever the staff reading is more, that means your reduced level will be less or more. I am saying reduced level. Huh? It will be less or more?
Less.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
Reduced level
it
will
is
be
the
less.
Height of the point from the datum, sir, and our staff rating is more, so that the level is down. Therefore, reduced level is less.
Reduced level is less. Correct. Okay. Now, one by one, we will understand the terms that we just read out. Okay. When we are reading out, maybe some people were not knowing, "Arey kya chal raha hai?" कुछ समझ में तो कुछ नहीं आ रहा है, राइट? बिकॉज वी वर नॉट हैविंग एनी इमेज इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस एंड इट वॉज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, सो हियर आई विल शो यू ऑल द टर्म्स सो दैट इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड, राइट? द फर्स्ट टर्म वॉज बेंचमार्क. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर सपोज टू डू द सर्वे इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया, राइट? सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया वॉट वी डू, we take a temporary benchmark, okay, which is visible from this particular equipment, right? So I will consider here, I will consider some benchmark over here, right? Yes, I have done it. Now, leveling about the equipment, I will discuss later. Okay, how to level that? That is a simple process. Okay, so first I have fixed my benchmark, and this I have considered as, say, 100. Okay, 100. 100 is the level of the top, this horizontal plane. Okay, the top surface is there, and this particular level, that we considered 100. Okay, now how to find the height of instrument? Our first step is what? We find out the height of instrument, isn't it? When we set up our equipment, first our task is
Yes, sir.
we find out the height of the instrument. Now, with the help of this picture, can anyone tell me how to find the height of the instrument?
Sir, benchmark plus reading of staff at this that benchmark point, it gives us the height of instrument.
No, first tell me where to put the staff.
Sir, at the benchmark.
Okay, shall I put it here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I did it. What next?
Sir, now we have to bisect the
okay.
staff.
Right. So I bisected. Okay, sorry. I'm not much good in the drawing. Okay. So this is say the line. Okay. Now
yes.
the reading that I got, consider it as say 1. I will say 35. It is in meter. Okay. This
yes,
is also
sir.
In meter. This is also in meter. Okay. What next I have to do?
Sir, 100 plus 1.35 equals it gives the height of the instrument.
Okay, height of instrument, you are saying this plus this. Are you sure?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anyone has any different opinion? Are it is very simple. Everyone is silent. So this is right. Okay. So your height of instrument will be 100.35. Yes, you got the height of instrument. Now, what next? What next you will do? So height of instrument will be 101.35, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What next you will do? अरे नो वन नोज हाइट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट निकाला तो सर्वे खत्म हो गया
नो सर सर्वे स्टार्ट हुआ सर अभी
या
सर अभी सर्वे स्टार्ट हुआ सर ये बेसिक पॉइंट स्टार्टिंग
स्टार्ट हुआ राइट अभी तो पूरा करने में बहुत आगे जाने का है
यस सर
सो व्हाट इज आवर नेक्स्ट स्टेप व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू डू नाउ इट इज वेरी इजी ना दिस 100.35 It is nothing but the level of the circular plane.
Yes, sir.
Right? The circular plane level is 100.35. That is what we call as a benchmark. Now it is very easy because you have got a reference plane whose level is known with reference to your benchmark. Now you are supposed to find say A point is here, B point is here, and C point is here, maybe D point somewhere here. Okay, so now my aim is I have to find A, B, and C, reduced level of A, B, and C. How you are going to do that?
By taking the staff reading at that point.
Yes, I will take the staff over here. Okay, I did it. I put the staff here. What next I will do? I will bisect.
Yes, sir.
Shall I? Okay,
yes, sir.
I will bisect. Now my reading is say 1.1. What you are going to do now?
Height of instrument minus 1.1.
So that what we will get?
Reduced level.
Reduced level of?
A point.
Good. So,
sir, we can. Sir, can you explain me the rise and fall method by this sketch? I got it the HI line of collimation method, but I can't understand the rise and fall method.
Okay, right now for that we have to prepare the sketch, different sketch. Okay, so I will cover
yes,
in the
sir.
Maybe next session I will cover that. Okay,
yes,
because
sir.
Right now
yes,
I have prepared for this only. Okay, there is not much difference. See, everything is same. Okay,
yes,
only
sir.
Thing is that with reference to that, where is rise and where is fall. You take a datum line, for example, like it is like this, isn't it? And you are taking one reference level. This is what is rise and this is what is fall. Okay, so in detail that we can discuss later. But concept is same, only a little bit twist is there, nothing else. Okay, so
okay,
so this is the reduced level of point A. Okay, then similarly I have to follow for point B, isn't it, or something different. I will put the stop over here, I will take this reading, I will get the RL of point B, right? Okay, then similarly I will get the RL of point C, right? Now my survey is over. Now very important point is there. Now what you are going to do next? Till then it is okay, fine, it was a bit simple. Next what we do? For example, our point is somewhere here and it is not visible from this point A, B, C, and say the D is here, E is here. Okay, so there are say 4 or 5 points at that particular area. So what you are going to do?
Sir, we can shift the instrument.
Yes, good. How you are going to shift that? That procedure is important. Yes, tell
sir,
me now.
First we have to shift the instrument, then we have to take a benchmark with respect to our first shifted position. Then we can start.
So
our,
first you will do, first you will shift this instrument over here, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, and sir. After that what you are going to do? You are going to level the instrument there, right?
Yes, sir.
After that what you will do?
Sir, we can find the height of the instrument.
How?
That. Sir, by connecting, by shifting the staff at that first position of our instrument.
First position is here, benchmark? Or here?
No, sir. Yes, sir, here.
Again, you will bisect this?
No, sir, no, sir. First stop, first instrument position, sir.
First instrument position, here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anyone has any different opinion than this? That's why I said this is very important point, because students get confused in this change point. Nobody knows. Okay. See, we cannot take the reading over here because this RL we don't know. Do we know this RL? We don't know. We know the RL of A, B and C. We don't know the RL of this particular point. Okay, therefore when we are shifting the point, this instrument at this location, then we should take the reference of the point whose RL are known. So whose RLs are known? This, this, this or this. You can take any one point out of this as a reference point. But in our table, what is shown? The last reading is foresight. Okay, on the same table, just a minute, I will show the table so that yes, here you are aware of this table.
Yes, sir.
Yes, so first reading is backside, then intermediate side as we discussed, then the last one is we call as a foresight. okay, we have given a different name to that particular point, foresight. And in the same row, we are taking backside reading. Have you observed this? In the foresight, in the same line, we are taking the backside reading. And the point is same. That means on point number 8, as we discussed A, B, and C. A, B will be written here, A, B, C, D, whatever it is. So point number 8, it will have two readings. One will have the backside reading and one will have the foresight reading. Right? And from that, we calculate the height of instrument. Again, I will explain in the 3D so that it will be clear to you. So, point A, point B, and say last point you are taking as a point C, right? So, your stop will be here, right? You are bisecting this, and after that, you are unable to see the point. That's why what you are going to do, you are shifting the equipment, say, here somewhere. Okay, and from here again you bisect the same stop. Don't change the stop location. Okay, once you decided that this will be the our last reading from here, then don't move the stop. Shift the equipment at this particular location. With the help of this particular location, we can find out the RL. We can find out the RL here. As we discussed, yes. Height of instrument minus this reading, that will give the RL of this particular point. Now we know the RL. Now we are going to move this equipment in that particular location. We are taking the reading, and this reading we write in the backside reading. I showed you in the table. So at one point, you are taking foresight from here and backside from here. Right? Now you know this RL, you know this height. Okay, so RL plus this backside reading, again it will give the what it will give?
HI.
Yes, height of instrument for the change point. And once you get the height of instrument, again continue with the same process. That is how it is done. Okay, understood? So this is just an equipment in the 3D. It was a little bit difficult to for you to understand in two dimensional. Okay, so this is nothing but your eyepiece. Okay, this side your object piece. Okay, and yeah, here when you see a stop from this particular eye hole, it is very difficult to check this level. This is the level bubble, right? To check whether your equipment is in the level or not. Okay, so that's why this mirror is given. So you can see the mirror of this particular bubble into the mirror, and when you are watching from this, okay, you will see the level, if the level is disturbed or what. This is your focusing knob. Once when you are watching the reading from here, to adjust the focus, you have to use this. And what about this? This is very important. Leveling screw, isn't it? So actually there is one method for leveling the equipment quickly. Right? I will just explain in short how to do that. Now consider my equipment is like this. So what I will do first, Yeah, what I will do, I will take any two leveling screws. Okay, I will make this parallel to this screws. Okay, just now I have made it. Okay, and then what I will do, I will rotate either in a clockwise direction, both clockwise or both anti-clockwise. Either this direction we are moving both inside, or I will move both outside. Right? I will level. Then again, what I will do? Again, what I will do? I will take this perpendicular to this foot screw. I will rotate this in a 90 degree. Okay. And then I will only rotate this screw either clockwise or anti-clockwise, depending on the how, where this bubble is moving, where this bubble is moving. So within say 2-3 attempts, you can level the equipment. Okay. And this is, you know what, it is a stand on which we fix the equipment. This is what is, this is stand, and the screws are given over here. These screws are given to adjust the height. Okay, this is actually telescopic arrangement is here. This member has a telescopic arrangement. It can slide up and down as per the requirement. Okay, so nothing is remained in this, I think. Yes, now I will come to the sketch again so that it will be easy for you to understand now. Okay, we have leveled the this one auto level. Okay, and first we have taken the backside reading. Okay, and we get the line of collimation level, that is we call it as a height of instrument. Okay, and once the height of instrument is received, then we can go for the RL of the next point, and this is what is called as a datum point, datum line. Okay, here with the help of the change point, we are explaining everything. So first our equipment is here. Okay, and this is where we are taking backside as well as foresight on the same point. Okay, and rest is the same as we discussed. So this is simply the process reading of staff. Variety of length of the staffs are available, and different types of staffs are available with respect to the material, wood, aluminium, fiberglass. Okay, the list count is 5 mm. What is that list count? What is the list count of any equipment? What is the list count? Definition. List count means what?
Minimum we measure that from that instrument.
Yes, good. Whatever minimum that we can measure with that instrument, that is called as a least count. Okay. It is important to hold the staff in a plumb. Right? If the staff is tilted, then there will be some error in the reading. Use vertical line in level to keep the plumb. 3 meter, 5 meter staffs are available. Note, keep unfold the level staff before taking the reading and lock switch back side of the level staff. Press until open maximum height of the staff. Abhi ye kya hai? And it is very, very critical. This note is very, very critical. I will tell you why it is very much critical. If you are not paying attention to that particular, then the whole survey may go wrong. If you consider 3 meter, there will be two, this thing, what? This staff is telescopic staff, okay? So there will be two sides, or you can say two elements of that particular staff, okay? This is when we open it, and there is one lock over here, okay? This is ground level. When we close the staff, it will be like this. Right? It will be like this. And for example, say this is 1.5 meter. This is 1.5 meter. And same here, it is 1.5 meter. Okay. So here our reading will start 1.5, then here it will be say 1.6, 1.7, 1.8, like that. Okay. By mistake, if the person who is holding the staff, he has not taken this particular element full out, and what he has done, the mistake he has done is like this. Only half the portion he take it out. So directly what you will see, only this reading. And after 1.5, immediately here you will observe the reading of say maybe 2 meter. So instead of 1.6, directly you are seeing here 2 meter, because this is gone inside and the person has not taken care that he has not fixed the lock. Only he has taken partially and you have taken the reading. So all the readings will be wrong, because on the basis of this reading you are going to calculate the further readings, isn't it? So when you are instructing the person to hold the staff, make sure every time he is locking this. Okay. Yes, so how to take the reading? So these are the markings. Okay, so this is 5 mm between these two. The thickness is 5 mm and the gap is also 5 mm. So just I will ask you something. Let me check if you can tell the correct answer. What? Yes. Can anyone tell me what will be this reading? If your crosshair, it is coming, it is coinciding with this line, what will be the reading? Can anyone tell? Good. 1.7070, right? Because this is given 1.075 and this is 5 mm, because the least count is 5 mm, so 1.07, that is what this reading is. Good. And this is all the theory. Okay, setting up the level, set up the tripod where you have a clear sight of the benchmark at a similar height, but preferably higher than the benchmark. Okay, why higher than the benchmark? If you are going down the benchmark, then it is not possible for you to see your benchmark, or it is not possible to see the reading when the staff is hold on the benchmark. If possible, set up the center of the area that you intend to survey. Okay, so or somewhere that you can see all the site, so that your shifting of the equipment will be minimum. You will cover the maximum point. That way you have to select the location for setting out the auto level. Release the catches of the each leg and extend to full length, close. Okay, this is all about the setting out the tripod. Okay, the tripod need to low enough for the smallest person on the site and to use the outlet. So you have to adjust the height. That is what it is saying. Place the level head on the base plate and attach it to the central screw beneath the base plate. I don't think it is there. Just a minute. Have we checked it here? Yes. Yeah. This point is very much important. Okay. Here, there will be one screw. It is not shown over here. Okay. So that will give the connection between this equipment and your tripod. So that is very much important. Otherwise, what will happen? This may slip and it will fall down. So when once this is leveled, you have to fix the that particular screw. With telescope parallel to two sides of the foot screw, that already I have explained you how to do that, turning opposite direction until the level bubble is at the center. Then turn 90 degrees so that the telescopic point toward the third foot screw. Okay, that is already explained with the help of that 3D. And once it is done, check all the direction, rotate your equipment in all the direction and check if the bubble is at the center in any direction. Then only you can say that yes, your leveling is done. If the leg are kicked or moved by mistake, you will have to repeat all above steps. By mistake, it is possible that the leg is moved and level is disturbed. In that case, again, you have to do the whole procedure. Taking the backside reading. Okay, the first measurement that you need to take is the backside reading. The person with the staff should place the bottom of the staff level on the benchmark, keeping it vertical. Okay, so staff should be in vertical position. Okay, it should not be tilted. The person at the level rotates the telescope until the central line or crosshair are lined with the staff. Okay, just a minute. So once when you are looking through this, what you are going to see? Yes, like this, isn't it? You will see like this. Actually, there is one vertical crosshair. It is missing over here, but it's fine. Okay. So you have to coincide your reading with this particular level, not with this, not with this. Right? Where central or the stradial cross here meets to the nearest reading. What do you mean by this? Meet the crosshair meets to the nearest reading. Means what? It is not always possible na, ki it will come exactly here. Sometimes it may happen that your reading is somewhere here. Okay, not here, but somewhere here. So in that case, which reading you will consider? Or you will interpolate?
No, sir. Which is near to the any one of them?
Why can't we do interpolation? If it is 5 mm, na, so approximately you can go for 2 mm, 3 mm, like that, na?
Yes.
So can you go for that?
I can go, but sir, it is very lengthy. मतलब टाइम कंज्यूमिंग होगा सर वो
हाँ टाइम कंज्यूमिंग होगा वो ठीक है दैट इज द प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी यू आर सेइंग बट द थिंग इज दैट यू शुड नॉट गो फॉर दैट व्हाई बिकॉज यूर रीडिंग विल बी रॉन्ग बिकॉज द लीस्ट काउंट ऑफ योर इक्विपमेंट इज 5 mm सो ऑल यूर रीडिंग हैज टू बी इन द डिफरेंस ऑफ 5 mm यू टेक एनी इक्विपमेंट ओके दिस इज द रूल दैट इज एप्लीकेबल If you are measuring with this, so difference should be 5 mm. Then which reading you are going to take, which one is nearer to that particular crosshair, then you can go for that. And that much error will be always there. For example, sometimes It is exactly at the center. Now you will be confused. Which shall I take? You can go for anything then, either down or up. If it is perfectly at the center, if it is nearer to the upper reading, then you can go for the upper reading. If it is nearer to the bottom reading, then you can go for the bottom reading. Okay? So this has to be in a multiple of 5 mm. Okay. So these are the formulas. So instead of remembering all the formula, it is always better to logically visualize the things, okay? And then you can remember how we are supposed to do, like height of instrument is equal to RL plus BS. So that will be very much easy and you will never forget that, okay? So this is one of the example, but I have already explained you in the 3D how we are going to take that particular levels, right? And this is what the table is, how generally the auto level table is. The last one is the benchmark, okay, here. So this is all about the auto level. Anyone has any doubt in this? No doubt.
Sir, first at benchmark point, we have to assume RL.
Right.
How many? Whatever it should be.
You can take anything. For example, okay. You can visually observe that your ground level difference is not more than 2 meter, right? If you take point A and say, the highest point A and the lowest point say B, and if you observe that it is not more than say 2 meter or 2.5 meter, then you know the difference is not more than 2 meter. That means even though you are going to do for the benchmark of say 5 meter, that is fine because it is a relative, isn't it?
Yes.
But generally many people, they take 100 because that is easy for the calculation. That's why they take 100, but you can take anything. Because that is a temporary benchmark. That is not one permanent one.
Okay, sir.
Anyone has any doubt? Okay. Then we will conclude. We will meet tomorrow. Tomorrow we will be going for contour survey. Okay. So time being, take care. Bye.